anointed. Why am I depressed?
Yes.
Why? Because my credit's jacked up, God. I'm reading about the faith and all this other stuff, but God, credit jacked up and things I didn't do and people doing stuff to me, and I just feel like I'm just helpless and I don't know how to come out of this, God. So worry about the past. I'm wearing somebody, my family's mask. I'm wearing somebody else's mask, a socket's mask, and everybody, people's mask from on campus and when I was in school, and I'm wearing this different mask. But God, how do I get this mask off me? Because I don't know how. How can I go to the next level? I want to be free, God. I can see, God, and I can hear, but God, how can I be free? But God, I don't want to live. I don't want to live, Lord, because it's just too much, God. The pain is just too much, remembering the past, the hell I went through as a teenager, God. God, and then getting married as a teenager, God. I've been through so much hell, God. How, God, am I just going to be free from this? I read it in the Bible.
Yes, Lord.
I read about miracles in here. Miracles, signs, and wonders. Yes, God. God, Joshua went through, Lord God. Oh, Joseph went through, Lord God.
I just began to eat me some vegetables. And all of a sudden, I listened to the
said, there's just somebody, you know, with your confidence, there's somebody in here. God's going to remove some stuff off your credit because you've been seeking the face of God. And I was like, oh, okay, just write this letter and tell them you're sorry for what you've done. I'm like, oh, yeah, really? But anyways, I did it anyhow. I got this letter in the mail and my credit score was clean, completely up. Because I chose. Yeah. I chose to obey God. Sometimes we so much. I went home to visit my mama. Church, I was on an assignment. Went to the prison first, but went to St. Louis first. This is my dad's dad. Go ahead and talk to my dad a little bit. He can tell me a little bit about his life. I'm like, good. At least I know how come I'm like I am now. Thank you for telling me. You know, then so I go to the prison to visit my brother. I completed that assignment, and so now I gotta go home. So I'm home and walk up in the door. My mother on the phone told me, I've been so sick. I've been sick. Then she get on the phone and she talked to, you know, one of my brothers calls. Mama, how you doing? I said, Mom, you ain't cough since I've been here. No, you know, so sometimes we be so much in our mess. We so much in this spirit of heaviness. Yes. So much in this spirit of same thing every single day. Yes. But the God sent me there to change the atmosphere at my mama's house. And so she got on the phone, she telling somebody else, well, I've been sick. I said, you've been sick since I've been here. I'm sorry, I can't help you. I'm sorry, I haven't heard you cough since I've been in your gym when I first walked in the door. I said, but you ain't sick now. And then she didn't have a car. And I said, you know, I said, Mama, do you believe? Mama was like, I said, well, okay, do you have faith at least as small as a grain of a mustard seed? Yeah. I said, okay, so my faith and your faith, we're tired, so let's pull on our heavenly bank account.
That's right.
I call it forth from the north, east, bless south, Lord, and the west. My mama's birthday was the 21st. My mama had her car.
Hi.
No, right. No, you, something about, I said, okay, I'm your daughter. Yeah. But you know what? I'm a son, not the carpenter's son. You may remember me as me as the carpenter's son, but I'm your child.
Yeah.
Yes, I am your child. Yeah. So I just want to encourage you today. Take off the mask.
Yeah.
So don't allow nobody to put a mask upon you.
Yeah.
Don't wear nobody else's mask.
Yeah.
It don't belong to you.
Yeah.
Don't wear no other prophet's mask, no prophetess mask, your mama, your daddy's mask. I don't care what they say. She speak with what she was on her heart, and she said, well, yes, I'm going to be like that. I sure am. Thank you very much. But then they said, you're going to have a whole bunch of kids. I said, yeah, oh, yeah? Well, guess what? You little nasty rascal. And the most of them who said that to those men, and they were trying to get in my underwear.
That's right. Come on,
as a teenager.
That's right. Say so.
And so every last one that tried to get up in my drawers as a teenager, they dead. You're dead. But there was one. He's still alive, and every time I come home, he look at me like he cock-eyed. Yeah. I don't know why he tells my mama, I don't know why come she don't like me. I said, look, what you need to do, the next time he say that, put him on the phone.
Uh-huh.
Put him on the phone, and let's have a discussion.
All right, boy.
Let's have that discussion. I was a tomboy, and I did do some stuff. I did. I jumped on the back of your truck. If you came by my house, I jumped on the back of your truck. If you had a bug, I jumped on the saddle and ducked down so you can't see me. And so he followed with me on that day. And so he going through. So what happened is he having to suffer to see his son. His son is suffering.
Uh-huh.
His son is suffering now. Because what he did, now you're going to get yourself together.
That's
whether
right.
God have him come tell me I'm sorry, whatever.
That's
however
right.
God does it.
Come on.
But I want to tell you, don't care. Don't wear the mask of sickness in your family.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, you say, well, diabetes in my family. Mm-hmm.
The devil.
Okay.
Come on, man.
High blood pressure in my family. The Bible said it's finished. The last time I read it says by his stripes you're healed.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And so I was looking at my family and laughing. And sometimes blindness has been coming to some folks. And so when she was a baby, you know, she was always getting hit in her eye. And the Lord just showed me, he said, okay, look at this. I said, oh, so this is right. It stops right here.
Yes.
And you can't cross over here. No, you can't because she got too much to do.
Right.
You ain't crossing up over here. And then my son, some stuff on the dad's blood. Like, no. You not crossing over here. If y'all want that, God bless every last one of y'all. But not up in here.
Right.
Not,
yeah, that's right.
Not my inheritance.
Yeah.
The devil is alive, the truth is not in me.
That's right.
If I have to fight, I'm going to fight with everything in me.
Right.
I'm fighting. Because those are my inheritance.
Yeah.
So Uncle Jara gave me these miracle children. And so I will fight for my children.
Right.
And so now I done got
that's
some
right.
Additional to our family. And these are my additions. They're trying to use our young men, our young women, whatever that you're doing, they're trying to use, take your kindness for granted. Right. They're trying to use you, but the devil is a liar. The devil is there, sharp as a spirit. And look at your eye, look at him looking. He's sharp as I don't know what his spirit. He'll sit there and read you like, I don't know what I sanitize them. I know they're not babies, but I can't help it. You just see, your eye gonna be real quiet, but he gonna be checking you out.
Come on,
all right,
yes.
And so, Uriah flew for the first time, and so did Israel, and so we just, and Joshua and Marcus had already flown. But so, God, this is just the beginning.
Yes, it is.
God has some great things in store for you. Great things in store for you. Great things. So I'm praying for y'all wives that they don't be jealous.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Well, you gotta understand. Why that girl couldn't have talked to you now? Well, she put in your hand. Well, baby, she gave me an offering. $1,000. Oh, okay. Okay, she can talk to you.
Amen.
So we just give God the glory. I love the Lord, and I was in this prison. I had my mask on, and I did. And I wore this mask for about 4 years. Anointed woman of God, but I wore this mask, and so I was in my own prison. And I didn't know when I was going to set free, but just like with Joseph, what the enemy meant for evil, God turned around for good.
Amen.
And so the enemy thought he had me, but God used it strengthen me. God used it so that others can be set free. And I'm determined to run this race for Jesus because I'm sharper now when I look at a wolf. Yeah, you cast out the devil, but you're still a wolf.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're
standing at the
pearly gates, and the Lord will say, I don't even know you. Depart from me. You work of iniquity.
Bless the Lord.
So you got a devil, so you're not coming in. But yeah, you was a hoe. You was casting out the devils. You did. And yeah, and they were healed too. I gave that to you, but how many women did you mess up?
Ooh,
how many
kids
did you mess up on your wife?
That's
how many
it.
Men did you sleep with?
Yeah.
You lied and you manipulated and you stole
that's
money.
It.
You did all this and I told you to go over here. You didn't
do
it. So you departed from the work of iniquity.
That's right.
And those that we call hoes and everything else, you see them all in the kingdom just waving at you.
Come
you didn't think I was going to make it out of here. And the Lord said, I'm going to spend time. So I said, you know what? I don't care what my job is doing. I'm taking off today. It's Jewel. I don't care who called me. I don't care if my mama called me. I don't care if somebody dad. I'm not talking to nobody. I got to spend time with the King. And so when I went into my room and I got on my face before the Lord, you know, the Lord told me to start these TV programs. I'm like, Yes. I said, oh, you know what? Okay, I remember the tree. So, okay, whatever you want me to do, it's on.
Okay.
So I went up there that same week, and, you know, bam, it was done. And so the TV program, you know, think about it, you know, I don't like being in front of folks. I don't. But you know what? Whatever God say do,
bless
the Lord. Because God's people has a word. God's men and women of God has a word from the Lord. He has a word to minister to God's people. Somebody has a word to set captives free. And so, God, whatever that you want to do, God, so be it unto you. And the chosen kings that came on, and I'm so grateful.
Yes.
My
yes.
children, they done one by themselves. I said, mommy not going to have this TV program. You can't do one. And so They did teach a program, and they did a wonderful job. And so, Pastor Julia came, and she did one, and Pastor Monica came and supported her, and she was set up by God that day. And so, I'm just really, really thankful that Miss Jewel and Minister Jewel Francis and Evangelist Rosa Blue has come and been on the program as well, and so they definitely supported us, and so I am just really, really grateful. But if you just need prayer, please come. I want to touch and I want to agree with you. But before we go any further, I'm going to be obedient.
Hallelujah.
Before we go any further, the Lord told me to do this, and I'm going to obey God. I'm going to obey the Lord. And so I just trust Him. I got to trust God. So the Lord told me to get this while I was out. And I just trust Him.
I just trust Him.
Praise God.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, glory.
So I just trust Him.
Hallelujah.
I just trust Him.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Awesome about the Lord is that He always blessed seed sowers.
Yes.
Seed sowers.
Yes.
She has sowed, she's given
yes.
to where she couldn't give out no more. If she could have boo-booed it out, she would have. And she has given. This woman of God didn't have this conference taken off the mask for her. She had it for us.
Yes.
And she's determined to do whatever God has called
bless
her. Who's standing for her behind her chosen kings? She is determined to do whatever God has called her to do. So we come against, and I want you to stretch your hands to her, church. Stretch your hands and lift up fresh oil ministry.
Hallelujah.
Pray in tongues. Those who pray in tongues, chosen kings, just loose your mouth and just let it go. You're filled with the Holy Ghost. Don't doubt it, just flow. We call money from the north, east, south, and the west. And the Lord, chase her down. The Lord, in the name of Jesus. The Lord, yeah, the Lord, I'm calling those who have an offering. Come down.
Jesus,
oh, God, we thank you.
Jesus,
oh, God, we bless you.
Jesus,
oh, Jesus,
Lord.
Chosen Kings, I need you to stand behind her, and I need you to pray with me, with this woman of God.